Today we're going to explain some of the basics of hypoglycemia, so stay tuned. Hey, I'm Dr. Ekberg with Wellness for Life, and if you'd like to truly master health by understanding how the body really works, make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss anything. What is hypoglycemia? Hypo means low or under, and glycemia means glucose in the blood, sugar in the blood. So hypoglycemia is low blood sugar. And then most people would think, well, if you've got low blood sugar, then let's eat a bunch of sugar to get it up. And that seems like a tempting idea, and that's what a lot of people do. And in the short term, that's going to sort of reset your blood sugar, and you feel better for a short time. But in the long run, it is the worst thing that you can do, and it is the thing that caused the problem, and it's the thing that perpetuates it. So let's look a little bit about how the system works. So blood sugar is measured in milligrams per deciliter, and your body likes it somewhere between 80 to 120. A fasting blood sugar should be 80 to 100, with a sweet spot somewhere like 85 to 90. And with that level of blood sugar, your body can produce stable energy long term. No huge peaks, no sudden valleys, but we have steady supply. That's what the brain likes, that's what your cells like. And 100 milligrams of blood sugar means that at any given time, the average person has about 1 teaspoon of glucose or sugar circulating in their blood. That's their energy supply, so to speak, from blood sugar. And that's like a slow drip. It's not like throwing a whole bucket in all at once. So if your system is designed for about 1 teaspoon of glucose or carbs at a time, then it doesn't know what to do. It's an emergency, it's a crisis if we dump a whole lot more than that in at any given time. So processed foods go into the bloodstream very, very quickly. So when we say sugar, we're not just talking about open up a bag of white sugar and start spooning it into your mouth. It is just as bad. Your blood sugar rises equally quick from a number of other things. So let's take a look. A Coke will have 8 teaspoons of sugar. A bagel, 10 teaspoons of sugar. Fries, 12 teaspoons of sugar. A muffin, 15 teaspoons of sugar. And if you go all out and you have 3 slices of pizza, that's 24 teaspoons of sugar. And your body is designed to have about 1 teaspoon at a time. That's what it knows how to deal with. So let's look at what happens. First, we have to understand insulin in relation to blood sugar. So when we eat whole foods like meat and vegetables, the blue line here, our blood sugar is going to stay within a very narrow range. It's going to rise slowly and it's going to drop slowly. And we only need a little bit of insulin to help that sugar out of the bloodstream and into the cell. But if we eat one of these foods or any processed modern convenience food, then blood sugar is not going to stay in the hundreds. It's going to go very, very quickly, in a matter of minutes, not hours, but minutes, it's going to get into the 200, 300 range sometimes. And that's an emergency. Just like a diabetic can get a coma from extremely low blood sugar, they can get a coma from really high blood sugar. The brain really doesn't like those huge swings. So this is an emergency, and the body is going to produce an emergency amount of insulin. So you get this huge red spike of insulin to handle all that excess blood sugar. But if the insulin goes this high and it tries to get that blood sugar out very, very quickly, the blood sugar is going to drop very, very quickly. And do you think that at that sudden drop with that huge amount of insulin, do you think it's going to slow down and just smoothly taper off at the ideal level? No, there's too much insulin in the system, so it's going to overshoot. And down here is what's called hypoglycemia. And now you get fatigue, you get irritable, you get shaky, you lose focus, you can't concentrate, you get in a bad mood, until you can get your hands on some sugar. Because when you're really down here, when you're really far down, that's an emergency too. You can't function down here and your body is screaming, give me some blood sugar. And now you go to the vending machine and you have something quick, a candy bar, a food bar, an energy bar, something, a Coke, chips, whatever. And now we get the spike and we're on this eternal blood sugar roller coaster. So what caused the problem of hypoglycemia was the sugar, because the processed sugar creates a roller coaster. The solution, even though in the moment, the thing that will be the quickest to make you feel better when you're down here is sugar, again, that's the worst thing that you can do in the long run because it perpetuates the problem. The only way to solve this long term is to stay away from these foods, learn what low glycemic index foods are, meat, vegetables, fat, and teach your body how to get back into this range to where it knows how to produce stable energy. Hope that was helpful. If you enjoy content like this, make sure that you subscribe and hit that notification bell. And if you know someone who has hypoglycemia or blood sugar issues or diabetic or insulin resistant, make sure that you share this content with them because it can be life-saving. Thanks for watching.